Hey YouTube, ID4Can here, and today we are going to check out a new application you can use on the ID4 and ID3, and that's called the Car Scanner. I have this Car Scanner Pro. I paid for it for other stuff, but I guess you can use it without paying it just to read the values, etc. OBD2 adapter. I have the VPeak BLA Plus. I'm connecting it currently on my OBD port on left under, and then we are starting our application. Before we connect, I'm gonna go through the options you need to select before you can connect to this car with this application. This is an Android application. I'm not sure if it also has the Apple application, iOS application, so I guess it has, but this is with Android. So first thing, you need to create a profile if you're starting up, and it will just tell you what it is. And this is the what I have, just a new car, etc. Just then you go to your settings, connection, and then select Bluetooth, select your device, in this case VPeak, and then the most important row is choose your connection profile. If you select Volkswagen, you will see this as first. You need to scroll down, and then you'll see the ID3 and the ID4. Great, right? Nice. Now, we selected the profile, and then that's it, basically. You go back, and for our metric people, go to your interface and units, and then press this toggle here, imperial or metric. Just put the metric and some other interesting. If you toggle this one, you will see it will show in kilowatt. So that's great. And the others you can just change to your liking, like this too. So that's that. Let's go back. Everything is recording. Yes, that's great. Everything is recording it. And then we will just go back, press connect, and then it will connect automatically. You need to have car in enabled, so the ignition needs to be on. If it's not like the EV Notify, where you can connect while the car is offline, with Car Scanner the car needs to be ignited. So press the brake pedal and the car will start. So you can, as you can see, it's connected. You see my fin, which I blocked it off, and we are ready. Actually, four things which is interesting on this whole application is dashboard, live data, all sensors, and acceleration tests. The others are currently not that interesting, but let me show you. I don't have a code. You can freeze a frame. This is nothing. It doesn't show you anything. Data recording. This is interesting if you want to keep your data out. Emission test, which emissions, you know. And statistics is when you're driving, etc., and you're saving your data, which I didn't use to this day. So before we go to your dashboard and live data, let's see what you can read with this application. That is with the all sensors button. Now you press on the all sensors. As you can see, it's something like 20 sensors, and these all sensors, voltage, calculate engine load, which is interestingly at 100 while being shut off, vehicle speed is not your dash speed but your GPS speed, so there's some calculation somehow, so that's great. Also handy when you're doing the acceleration test, so you show the 0 to 100 in GPS speed. What do you have more? Hybrid EV, battery charge. If I'm looking currently what my current charge is, it's 41. 41 is my state of charge currently on my screen, so that's interesting. Absolute pedal position, now it's on the rest stand. I press it and it should be at 78, and when I press the kickdown, 86. Good. And what do we have more? Average speeds, hybrid battery power. I'm currently consuming on my dash, on my infotainment, it says 300 watt, 0.3 kilowatt. And it says here, a hybrid EV battery power, it says minus 1 kilowatt. But at the DC battery power, it says 0.33. So that's right. This DC power, that's the right value what I see on my infotainment. Now, you go back, charge state of BMS, not true charge state of display, also not true. So it's really interesting to see some difference. So I don't know where this value is coming. Charging rapid port, charging charge port, normal charge port, and the interesting 3 points are the last three. Battery inlet, battery minimum, and battery maximum temperature, and these are correct. So that's interesting if you want to follow your battery temperature, etc. What now? The interesting thing about this application is you can use your own dashboard, so with what you want to show on your phone. So if you press on dashboard, I already pre-configured this dashboard. Normally you will start with this, second one will be this with not selected live data, and as last you will have this with, if you press on the gear button, customer space, and if you press on the table, you would have like three options. But as you can see, you can even show 15 statistics, but I thought 12 was all the thing I needed. And then you have your 12 options. You press on the gear, and then you have on your sensor, the sensor you have already seen earlier, you can select and show it on your dashboard. Now go back. I did this for everything. You can even select to show the minimum and maximum, and even change color depending on the temperature. So it's really customizable. Okay, all right. So yeah, how does this look? If I go back and say okay, it looks like this, when it is perfectly fine. Only my state of charge display BMS of any author is not correct, with at least not corresponding with the display I see. So there's some difference in value. It may be correct what you see, but it's still not correct what you can't compare with what you see on your display. So it's a bit strange. But the other things, DC battery voltage, DC battery current, battery power, inlet, and the most important thing, battery temperature, it's there. And you can just see it on the battery temperature, which when your car is maybe enough hot to get or to receive the high power charging. So how easy it will be charging 125 or 100 kilowatts. So in this case, it won't even have a problem to hit the maximum on the curve. I have currently 41% state of charge, and I may hit 60, maybe 70 with this percentage and with this temperature. So it's not high, but like you would do when you were charging from 10, let's say 10%, and around 40%, it will be around 80 or 90. But when you plug it right now with 40%, you may get 70 tops. So to keep in mind in the future, if you want to charge fast, lower or drop your amount of charge, state of charge, and then fast charge. So yeah, and that was the screen. And as last, live data. Yeah, you can just show live data, and let me show you all the batteries, temperature, and you will have a nice screen with all the data you have on your, or nice charts with all the data you have selected. In this case, I did select my temperature of my battery, and then you will see on the go it will just rise or lower. So yeah, that's not that interesting for now. As last one, acceleration test. Tada! You start with 3 of 5 lines. I selected from 0 to 0 to 110, 120. Brake distance and then for a quarter mile distance, the time of it. So let's do this as last part of this video and then let's wrap it up. 41% at comfort. Let's put it on sport and let's go. 3, 2, 1. So what did we get? 8.36. 0 to 100, right?
Yeah.
That is awesome. That is awesome. I didn't expect it this fast actually with only 40%. But this is great. So thanks for watching. This was Car Scanner for the ID3 and ID4. We went through the application, we did a 0 to 100 acceleration test. And thanks for watching. I will see you again in my next video. Later!